We're making fun of him. He has a weird accent and all that, and he's very tiny too, and it's always fun to pick on short people, especially if you don't like them. Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Ryan here. We're doing part 4 of the Sly Cooper Let's Play. Whoa. Hold on a second. What day is it? It's Monday. Oh, well then that means we're totally in the new sort of a setup we're doing here, which is 3 Let's Plays a week from now. We're going to give it a shot. Seemed like there was a pretty semi-positive response to it, I guess you could say. I just want to do it anyway, so I feel like it'd be a better idea. I think we'll do alright, you know. Obviously, I'm not off to a great start on this boss battle. We're going to take out El Jefe. This was probably the easiest, or not easiest, easily the hardest boss fight in Sly Cooper Thieves in Time, which is a little disappointing considering there are many other boss fights later in the game. Not that it really matters, you know, in terms of challenge, I guess you could say, since Sly Cooper is generally a pretty easy game, but... it was kind of disappointing that the hardest fight was this fight, which is the first one. But there's even a silver trophy for beating El Jefe without taking any damage. So obviously, even the developers themselves know that he was a challenging fight. I'm gonna try and stay a little focused here, because since he does have a lot of moves and requires you to swap to the samurai suit, I should probably stay semi. Focused here. Ah, shit. Fuck that up. I totally bunced that. Shout out to Gavin from Rooster Teeth. He's like rubbing off on me. I watch so much Rooster Teeth videos that I just can't help myself. What can I say, man? YouTube. I spend half my day watching it, and then I spend another half of my day making videos for it. I died. But that's alright, because now we've got all of our health. I kind of prefer that I die. But we're gonna try and take care of business here. My controller died prior to starting this. I was watching some Netflix. Then right on the little good old Netflix TV show, it was just like, oh dude, your controller's about to die. You know, the little PSN notifications popping up and all that. And I was like, oh Jesus Christ. And it's a pain because, I have one of those like charging stations. So I can just plug in my DualShock. So I don't even have to ever touch cords really. And it like doesn't charge controllers anymore. I don't know. I've had it for like 3 years, and it just doesn't do the job anymore. It can't charge a DualShock that long, so I'm not sure why that happened. But I think it also lies with my DualShocks in general, because my DualShocks are extremely old, pretty much since the day they came out. Keep in mind though, it's that you know the 6-axis came out first, and you know DualShock wasn't on PlayStation until people complain about it, and then Sony finally brought it back. But even still, my DualShocks are rather old, and I don't know, they just can't hold charges anymore. And I don't know. I feel like, I mean, you know, choosing to play on PlayStation, that was one of the things that we had to pay for that shit, because you know, back in like the good old console wars, I guess you can say, where people used to really bitch about stuff like that. It was like PlayStation fans would say, "Oh, our controllers are PlayStation gamers would be like, "Oh, our batteries or our controllers are rechargeable," and Xbox people would be like, "Oh yeah, well your lithium-ion batteries, those are gonna run out in fucking 5 years." And you know, obviously we didn't care back then, but yeah, we're paying for this shit now. Man, I'm just fucking this up left and right. The second wave's much harder. Got some health back. Maybe we can try to take care of business here. If I can remember everything. Gotta try and stay focused here. And this is obviously, if you're watching this already, this Let's Play is not gonna be as long as, you know, 40 minutes. And someone even mentioned that, you know, they don't have 40 minutes to watch one video. And I can understand that. A lot of people don't. That's why I kind of reconsidered the whole idea of doing more of them for less time. I felt like that would really work out better. Okay, I got even more health, and I'm beating his ass. I think we can do it here. As long as I can stay focused. Maybe I can start to redeem myself. Maybe do some better LPs around here. I know one dude was upset about some of the failures I have on the Let's Plays. But, you know, it's not like I care, really. I mean, I care about viewing experience, but... Ah, I fucked that up. That's the thing about the samurai suit. You can't switch to it that fast, which I found to be also a semi-small annoyance in this little boss section fight. But otherwise, a standard platforming boss. Gotta just dust off those PS2 skills. Aw, shit. Oh, see, now he's switching to that. Oh, thank God I saved that right there. But I think we still got one section of a fight for this guy. He's a Rasky. What the fuck is Rasky? Made up that word. He's a tough little critter. Well, it kind of sounds like, I don't know. See, you hear the word critter and you think of small animals like armadillos or, I don't know, like rats even. But, I mean, that's a fucking tiger right there. All this dude does is talk shit, you know? I don't know what's scarier. And in response to the one guy who was like, okay, we'll make a Q&A video because, you know, he likes the personal aspect of how I, you know, try and talk to everybody. And for the most part, I definitely do try to do that. But I just don't really have the time to make another video that where I'd, like, be on camera, for example, and do, like, Q&A and all that. And I just think that's kind of douchey to do that many Q&A videos where I'm on camera. I'm not that important of a person, trust me. So, that's why I feel it'd be generally... I think that's the word of the day for this video, the word generally. I think for the most part, I can still answer Let's Plays, even though they're going to be pre-recorded. They're not going to be super pre-recorded. I would just pre-record the three parts for that week. So I could still keep up with questions that are, you know, asked in previous, like, you know, episodes of the past three episodes. I'm kind of trying, I don't know if I'm making sense, purely because I'm trying to stay a little focused here. I've got a whole lot of health. I just want to take care of El Jefe. That's one part I really don't like about the third section of this fight. Is you really do not have a lot of time to swap out of the samurai suit to avoid that, like, electric move he does. Not this one, but the one that I just died on previously. But yeah. So a lot of news broke after LTPS, and I usually like to upload Let's Talk PlayStation early Friday. So Friday morning. God damn it, asshole. So like Friday morning, but that, so since it is Friday morning, that leaves opportunity for, you know, news to break on that Friday that I can't get to. Son of a bitch. So a lot of new, obviously it's PAX. PAX is going on. There's some stuff coming out about that, like the DuckTales remaster and Walking Dead coming to Vita, and obviously the most interesting news story for me, at least. I don't even think this came out at PAX. Yeah, this was just sort of a thing people noticed. Oh shit. Yeah. When I talk, I just overlook things. The ESRB has rated the, oh, I'm fucked, yeah. See, it's so hard for me to talk and play sometimes. The ESRB has rated the Jak and Daxter collection for Vita. Oh, yeah. This really is happening. And that's awesome, right? I mean, obviously, woo, for me, you know, Jak and Daxter, favorite series of all time, so I'm totally down for that. Damn it, I'm getting my ass kicked here. Wow, I just decided, you know what, I'm just gonna leave. I just don't even want to fight this guy anymore. And, that's pretty much it. I'm assuming, obviously, it would be separate trophy lists, so you bet your ass I'm buying that shit, and I am playing it again for 6 Jak and Daxter. Oh, why'd I swap out? Oh, I still made it. 6 Jak and Daxter Platinums, which would be awesome. So Jak 1, Jak 2, and Jak 3 on Vita, and then Jak 1, Jak 2, and Jak 3 on PS3. Totally down for that, right? Ah, god damn it. Fucking samurai suit pisses me off sometimes. I can't even, it's so hard, this is so hard to avoid. There we go, come on. I don't know if he's gonna keep going. Okay, hold on. I got shit to say, but I'm gonna take care of business here. There we go. And ironically, there's still a part after this. He's not done yet, I think. Or maybe he is done. Oh, I thought there was still a part after his health's gone. Maybe I'm referring to another boss fight later on. There's a cane, though. And he's like, oh, I think I'm gonna get that, but uh-oh! Oh, no. Oh, no. Those bastards. That's gotta be a mouse, right? I would assume. Rats don't have that big of ears. Unless it's like a Dumbo rat. There's La Paradox looking at us and shroud in mystery. There's his big blimp. It's pretty cool. Then we get a little bit of a trinket as to where we're going next. Not sure if you knew where we were going. Yep, that dude's time traveling. Sly's pretty shocked. Did you guys know my rat's name, Sly? El Jefe was defeated. Yeah, my rat's name, Sly. I don't know if I ever said that. But it was a hollow victory. Lock that bitch up. I failed to get back Ryuichi's cane, and we still had no idea who was really behind this whole thing. One thing was for sure. So stinky. Somebody powerful enough to have his own. You can just see all of his like stink floating around everywhere. Tennessee Kid Cooper. The Wild Wild West. That meant we needed to travel back to the 1880s. Luckily, one of the goons that took Ryuichi's cane had dropped what looked like an old sheriff's badge. Bentley had been trying to figure out where it might be from, but now it all made sense. After sampling the badge, Bentley was able to calibrate the time machine. As we prepared to make the jump back to the Old West, I found myself wondering how Carmelita was doing. Yeah, so, anyway, I got a bunch of ideas brewing around in the old noggin of mine, and since a lot of you guys are very vocal, I can obviously gauge some of your opinions, and I think I'm going to do that. Obviously, we were talking about the Jak and Daxter collection coming to Vita, and, you know, if the ESRB rates it, it's probably going to be true, you know, it's why else would they be rating it? So, yeah, I had a couple ideas stirring around. Obviously, since I just played Jak and Daxter for, you know, the Let's Play on YouTube, that's the second time I got the Platinum in Jak 1, so this would make it a third time if it comes out on Vita and I plan to get it. So I feel like I'm pretty fresh on playing the game, so I could, like, I don't know, like, you know, like, I could probably take, you know, go through the game much faster than I did before. Because now I remember some of the things I misstepped and forgot and stuff like that. So I was thinking, who would be interested in watching a marathon live stream of when the Jak, if the Jak and, which I think it will, that when the Jak and Daxter collection comes out on Vita, who would be interested in watching a live stream of me doing the Jak 1 Platinum from start to finish? Because I feel like I could knock it out in like, the goal would be like under 5 hours. Obviously, I don't expect anyone to watch all that, but who would like jump in and out and be interested in seeing something like that? And then I was also thinking, because Bioshock Infinite's coming out soon, and I'm super pumped about that. I love Bioshock. I'm obviously gonna play the game first and enjoy it and all that, and then post a review. But obviously, one big thing in Bioshock Infinite that everyone's talking about is Bioshock Infinite's 1999 mode, which is the extremely tough. Basically just the hardcore mode in the game for people to play, and that's pretty much what it is. It's a really hardcore mode. I guess there's like no resources in the game, you know, the save points and all that aren't very forgiving and all that. You can't save wherever you want, and I thought maybe I could do I guess it would still be a Let's Play, but a walkthrough of it, I guess, because I'm definitely getting the Platinum in Bioshock Infinite, and I'm wondering maybe we could maybe venture on into that sort of aspect of content where it's like Let's Plays are in, you know, these sort of videos are generally, I'd say maybe, I don't want to say entertainment because I'm certainly not entertaining, but I guess it kind of would fall under entertainment. But like a 1999, I guess, would definitely be considered a more walkthrough sort of thing. And in that, if I were to do something like that, I obviously would definitely cut deaths and definitely maybe offer strategy and all that. Because, I mean, there's like a lot of games that I do suck ass at, but you know, I have like 56 platinum, so for, you know, I do know what I'm doing sometimes. Maybe that would be interesting. And lastly, which I'm not really gauging opinion, I guess, but more so trying to build up sort of excitement for this. I think it was part 9 in the Jack and Daxter's Let's Play. I talked about a new series, so I'm giving an update on it. It's coming along. I recorded a bunch of episodes of it, and I've begun editing on them. And the first episode of this new series will be going up probably mid-April, maybe early April. I'm not entirely sure. March, April. Yeah, April comes after March. Sometimes I don't know my shit. Anyway, I'm really excited about it. Like, I'm super pumped. Like, I really think it would, you guys will like it. And, I don't know, I like content creating. It's been pretty fun so far. Haven't really said much about anything regarding Sly. Obviously, we just saw the cutscene about Tennessee Kid Cooper. Came back to the past in the West. Tennessee is locked up. Obviously, every generation of time we go in and Sly Cooper Thieves in Time, something has gone wrong. And what has gone wrong here is that, you know, there's all these bulls that are here and all that, and there's a new mob boss running the Wild Wild West, and they've locked up Tennessee Kid Cooper. He has been framed. Obviously, Kid Cooper shouldn't be locked up because he's Kid Cooper, you know what I'm saying? He's a Cooper. He knows what he's doing. But he's locked up, and that doesn't make a whole lot of sense, and we're going to see what's going on. So, we're gonna try and, make fun of the new mob boss here. Oh, look at that. Graffiti. We are young children. We are just mocking this guy left and right. We don't care about him. Loser. Little... He's an armadillo, right? Yeah, he's an armadillo. We're making fun of him. He has a weird accent and all that, and he's very tiny, too, and it's always fun to pick on short people, especially if you don't like them. So that's what we're doing right now. We're, you know, we're graffitiing. That's against the law. He's not gonna like that. He is not going to appreciate that whatsoever. We're trying to get his attention. We're trying to build a wanted level, I guess you could say, sort of Grand Theft Auto style. And once we get arrested, then we're gonna break open Tennessee and we're gonna be like, Tennessee, what's up, dude? I'm your what would that make him? Like, great, 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 like, but, like, what lineage, like, what kind of relation would he have? Grandfather, right? Because, like, yeah, I don't know, maybe, sort of. Not school smarts, although it's not school smart related, considering it's just family lineage. Although I never had, like, a project in school where it was like, oh, explore your family history. I never had anything like that. I see that on TV a lot, where, like, you know, there's episodes of, like, I don't know, fucking Brady Bunch or some shit, where, like, kids have to do lineage sort of things, and I never did that. Which is good, because I, quite frankly, don't give a shit about my lineage. Maybe that's a terrible mentality, but, terrible thing to say, but I don't know. I don't care about the past, really. Like, growing up in, like, school, like, I hated history. I hated history. Because history is just, like, remembering shit. That's all it is, just remember stuff. It's like, if you don't care about something, you know, then you're not going to remember it. And I don't care about history. And quite frankly, a lot of people don't care about history. And I understand history is important, though it's not necessarily too important. I understand, you know, educational needs for a certain point in your life. But it reaches a point where, you know, it really is unnecessary. You know, like, you don't need to keep learning history in college. Especially if it's not in any relation to your major or minor or any of interest, you know. But anyway, that's pretty, yeah, history's like, you just gotta remember shit, and that's just, that's just how the human mind works. If you're not interested in something, you're not gonna remember it, you know. If someone likes video games like me, I'm gonna remember stuff about it. Although, I definitely don't remember some things about, you know, Jack and Daxter. Or a lot of games in general. Although maybe that's just kind of brain overload, because when you play so many games, you know, it's hard to keep up with all of it. Where is this? Oh, it's right there.
This guy's a real egomaniac.
Sure, this dude sure does have an ego. Look at me, I'm a bucking bronco. I'm gonna put a picture of myself on a horse. And then his little buddies are laughing. Oh, there he is. Look at how tiny he is. I roll him up in a ball, and I play basketball with him. I'm sure he wouldn't appreciate that. Nice teeth, dude. Toothpick. What's the lowdown, Bentley?
Absolutely.
Apparently, the sheriff also loves lollipops, but his favorite is a particular Cuban variety, which has to be shipped in specially. Supposedly, they taste like...
He has a little finesse for lollipops.
Agreed.
But guess what? I'm gonna take it. Don't know if you can hear the audio. My rat's eating some food right now. And, I'm not gonna stop him, because, rat's gotta eat. Boop. Man, I don't see any problem with smacking a good old Clue bottle here and there, even though we're not gonna get all of them. Totally missed that. But we're gonna get this guy's candy. I was gonna say cane, but it's definitely not candy cane. Lollipop. I don't know why I thought candy cane. Christmas is nowhere near. Although I like Christmas. Great holiday. Boop, boop. Took his lollipop. And, then we gotta mess with this banner. I forgot what the next thing was after the lollipop. I'm like, because I know we messed with something else. But what? Why are those... Oh, yeah. Because they're health drops. So why is there little, critters always running around in, Sly games? But it just reminded me, like, Spyro always had that. Like, in all the Spyro games, there was always, like, certain levels just had those, little animals that would run around, and those were your health drops. What am I supposed to do here? I already got to it. Knock it down. Or did I? Oh wow, I gotta go talk about it first? Really? Dude, my thumbstick keeps sticking and then the camera keeps moving to the right.
Alright, this is going perfectly.
I was already over there, Bentley. Come on, man. I could have knocked him out.
You're a little too excited about sending me to the slammer, Bentley.
It's all about the job, Sly. Speaking of which, in case you hadn't noticed, this Sheriff Toothpick is his own biggest fan.
That's what I'm saying. That guy's way too into himself. He's the kind of person that looks into the mirror and, you know, like, thinks he's really attractive and, like, flexes biceps and then takes mirror pics and puts it up on Facebook, and he's just like, oh, gotta love them selfies. And then it's like, yeah, man, you gotta love being into yourself. Don't, no, I'm not doing anything. I'm not doing anything. Please don't shoot me. Thank you. Oh, and then the camera angle changes. Boop, 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 boop. The scribbling lolly thieving outlaw I've been looking for. He just kind of jumps down. Yeah, dude, totally. Take me in. Please. I know. You know what? No, I want to be arrested. Please, take me in. Wow, Sly is, like, so happy about that. And then that's when we get the jailbird costume, and we get to use a big ol', yeah, that thing. What do you call that? I mean, it's just a, you know, like, what would you call, does that have a name for, like, back in the day, Wild West jail people? Like, what was that big iron thing that they carried around? Wait. I don't know, anti-runaway mechanism? I don't know. It certainly work, I'll tell you that much. I wouldn't be able to lug that thing around. And you'll obviously see Sly won't be able to either, because when we swap to the jailbird costume, Sly's, like, holding that big-ass thing, and then he's very slow to move around and all that. My beard is itching like fucking crazy. I don't know if you can hear it, but I've been itching it the past few minutes now. I just fucking trimmed it, too. I don't know why it's so irritated. Well, man, I'd love to keep playing, and I'm actually going to since it's pre-recorded, but we're going to stop this part right here, part 4, on Monday. I'll see you Wednesday for part 5, so we're going to be moving along now, getting more content and all that, and it is definitely more content, 3 separate episodes, and since it's 25 minutes each, that means it'll be 25, way more minutes than you usually get compared to 40 minutes, you know what I'm saying? But thanks for watching. I'll see you Wednesday. I gotta think of a good outro now, because hey, thanks for playing with me. See you next Wednesday. I'm Ryan Benecki. Thank you for playing with me. I'll see you next Wednesday. I'll see you Wednesday. So it wouldn't be next Wednesday. I'm Ryan Benecki. Thank you for playing with me, and I'll see you Wednesday.